sun, sea, palm trees, beach 11 shooters on a tropical island for weak PCs. One of the main components of games, for which the decision to buy a game is made, is the graphics. It is the graphic beauty that lures players from CD covers and video trailers. The most vivid and colorful opportunity to demonstrate the graphic capabilities of the game is to build a game location on a tropical island. This is based on a person's desire for recreation. The game is a vacation. A tropical beach is a vacation, so their symbiosis is born by itself. Everyone will agree that it is much more pleasant to the eye to look at the iridescence of light on a sandy beach between palm trees at sunset, than to wade through dark, poorly lit corridors. Of course, game developers do not live on the same beach, but developers from different countries often resorted to the idea of shootouts on a tropical island. Today I picked up 11 shooters on tropical islands for weak PCs. This is important for most gamers who do not have a powerful iron, to visit resort places without leaving home, while getting a high-quality image on the screen. Far Cry, the legendary game of 2004, that is, it is already 16 years old. In those years, it was a graphic breakthrough. Green tropical vegetation seemed to literally fall out on the player from the monitor. The island in the South Pacific at that time left no one indifferent. Just Cause is a 2006 game that is 14 years old. The very first part of the series Adventures of CIA Agent Rico Rodriguez. A large open world, a group of islands covering 1,025 square kilometers. A lot of weapons and transport. As well as yellow sand, palm trees and blue water. Crysis is a 2007 game. The game is 13 years old, but even now it looks amazing at maximum settings. This was a technological breakthrough. The game was a kind of demonstration of the then newfangled DirectX 10 engine. Special Forces Soldier of the Federal Security Service of Russia, a 2007 game created with budget money. Only the first mission takes place on board the ship, but all the others, on a tropical island. The game was released simultaneously with Crysis, but the difference between them is like between a village cart and a Rolls Royce. However, the game has nice tropical views. Sun, sea, palm trees, beach, shooting, all available. Crysis Warhead is a 2008 game. It is a side branch of Crysis. Still the same island, only the view from the side. In those years, nothing more beautiful and technological did not exist, and in 2020, the picture in the game looks much better than in many modern games. Lost, Viadamas is a 2008 game based on the TV series of the same name. You crash on a plane on a tropical island and have to solve the riddles of the island. By and large, this is a quest, but with the elements of a shooter. In the arsenal of your hero will be a gun and ammunition for it, and although you will not have to shoot often, but still have to. The beach with the remains of the plane and a group of survivors is a quiet haven where you can relax, while in the interior of the island you will have to work hard. Xenas 2, White Gold is a 2008 game developed by the Ukrainian studio Deep Shadows. Despite its age of 12, the game looks very good. Programmers squeezed all the juice out of DirectX 9 to please the players. Unlike the first part, where the location is located deep in the Colombian jungle, the second part takes place in the middle of an archipelago of several large and a large number of small islands. Also in the game you can buy your own island and invest in its arrangement. Pirate Hunter. Somali Trap is a 2009 game. The main character of the game is a Navy SEAL Igor Kotov, looking for his wife in the Pacific Islands. Graphically, the game is not outstanding, but passable. Postrelushki on the island in stock. Just Cause 2 is a 2010 game that is a direct sequel to the first part. The meaning and plot remained almost the same, only the graphics improved. The island with palm trees became even more beautiful. Dead Island is a 2011 game. The location is located on a tropical resort island in Papua New Guinea. You are one of the few surviving tourists. Your enemies are the same vacationers turned into zombies. The beaches are not as beautiful and detailed as in Crysis, but they are very good and leave a pleasant impression. Dead Island, Riptide is a 2013 game. It is a direct continuation of the original game. After leaving that first island, you arrive on the second, in the hope that there are no zombies here, but they are also there. Palm trees, sea, beaches are also good and attractive. This is the end of a selection of beautiful and not demanding beach shooters. Right, what other shooters do you know on tropical islands for weak PCs?